Siyavara Ramachandra ki jai, Pavana Sudha Hanuman ki jai, Radhavara Krishna Chandra ki jai, Guru Vai Sabasantan ki jai, Jai Nama Parvati Pataye,
children is allowed to go from here. Okay? Yeah, bring your books, study in the class. Today is all the 10 avatars of the Lord which will be told. Including Saket. I can't see Saket. He is the escapist. Hiding under the table. Okay, then it's okay. Don't allow them to escape, okay? You are my spies. Okay, so we are in Bhagavatam, and last week we saw the concluded the chapter on the names and characteristics of various siddhis, mystic powers acquired through yoga. So what was the essence in the end? What is a siddhi? What is a siddhi? The potential that is lurking, hiding, unmanifest inside each and every one of us. See, these kids are coming. He is also coming. They are coming to study Sanskrit. They didn't know Sanskrit. He didn't know the a e e ka kha ga ga cha cha cha. He did not know. But he is the best among all the students because all others are kids. he's a big kid. But even though it is not his language, because of his interest and his commitment and purpose that I must get a hang of this language, he's invoking that potential from within, isn't it? Same way, when he came first time to learn Vedic chanting, this fellow was the teacher in the ashram. But I am not a Vedic chanting teacher. But now he chants better than me. Without looking, I have to look. And his diction and intonation is much better than mine. Where was it? It was hiding. So from every person, it's not that one teacher for all, one God for all. No, not like that. For every person, there is someone who can invoke that out. Sometimes children don't listen to their parents. So you ask some third person, some uncle or some teacher or some Mahatma, please tell him. And then he tells the same thing and the child listens. Why? He's able to invoke it out of him. See? So this potential, what is the ultimate potential in every one of us? What is the ultimate potential? Huh? Recognition of our essential nature. Put it in other words. Someone said something.
We are divine.
There will be no one left to say we are divine. So what is the ultimate potential? Self-realization, becoming one with God, merging into God, immortality, whatever words you want to use. You are using these words because you are not there yet. When you are there, you will forget all the words. When you are in abidance, just like when you are in sleep, you don't use any words that I am sleeping. Thank you. Only after waking up you say. But here it is different. When you are merged into divine, you know fully well, because you are awake, you are not asleep. And this potential is lying in every one of us. Bhagwan says that the purpose of our life is only one, to realize that we are essentially divine. And for that you have to raise your energy. Energy can be raised. Initials, you are not Ravan Maharishi, you are not Neem Karoli Baba, you are normal human being. So you have to sit straight. Only when the spine is straight, the energy will move upwards. Whatever energy. Energy. That's it. So it moves upwards. Just like fire always moves upwards, energy always moves upwards. Now, consciously, with regular practice, with regular application, with commitment, with dedication, with love and offering that practice to the Lord, practice every day. Don't complain. Don't complain. Because in the end, this Shakti which is lurking inside of us, which is expressing as Siddhi, its obstacle is only one. Tell what it is. Not mind. Mind is the only tool you have. How can it be obstacle? Neither you know the ego, neither you know the Maya. Tell me something that you know. Impure mind is the obstacle. Impure mind. So more than anything else, running for pilgrimages, going and doing pujas, if all that is not being done, even including this lecture, if it is not being done with the intention of purifying the mind, in my case because I'm speaking and in your case because you're listening, if listening is not for purification of the mind, then it's a waste of time. No, leave it. No interruptions. See? So our daily activity from morning till night, this is the Hindu way of life or the Sanatan way of life. What is that? Completely disciplined, so that we are ever aware of not allowing the corruption to enter into our mind. When does corruption enter into our mind? When we are lazy. When we are procrastinating. When we are too excited, when we are too sad, when we are everything doing in extremes, that's when the corruption enters. And what is our Sanatan way of life? Maintaining a balance. Samatvam yoga uchyate. And in the end, towards the end of this chapter, it was told that, here it was told in the 42nd verse, it was said, vacham yachcha mano yachcha pranan yachchendriyani cha आत्मनामात्मनायच्छ न भूय कल्पसे ध्वने यो वै वाङ्मनसि सम्यक् असंयच्छन् धियायति तस्य व्रतं तपोदानं श्रवत्याम घटाम्बुवत् तस्मान् मनोवच प्राणान् नियच्छेन्मत्परायणः मद्भक्तियुक्तया बुद्ध्या ततः परिसमाप्यते. सो दीज लास्ट थ्री वर्सेस, थ्री वर्सेस, ही सेज देयरफॉर पुट द फोन ऑफ प्लीज एवरीवन. Put it mute. Therefore, restrain your speech, curb your mind, control your breath, tame your senses and conquer your intellect with your sattvika intellect, and you will no longer be able to return to the path of transmigration. We did all this, isn't it? We concluded the chapter last week? Yes. And with this particular point, I told you our Swamiji in Vrindavan, Akhandananji's words he mentioned, what were they? Kaya se seva karo. Kaya means body. Kaya se seva karo. Indriyo se, indriyas mean the five sense organs and the five organs of action. With the indriyas, unhone bola, vash me karo. Means keep them under control. So here it is told, what? With the speech, restrain your speech, curb your mind. So all the senses you restrain. Fir man se, yahan pe likha hai restrain your mind, but there he said what? Man se prani matra ke prati sadbhav rakho. What was the meaning I told you? What is sadbhavna? The self in me is the self in all. That bhavana you have to keep. It's not logical that the life which is expressing through this body is the same life which is expressing through all the people. Then unconditional love will express. And that unconditional love doesn't mean that you will go and hug everyone or go and change the criminals and go to every hospital. If that is your purpose, you will do that. That Lord will reveal what is to be done. But that feeling, that continuously remaining in the disposition that the life in me is the same life which is expressing even in a mosquito, in a cockroach, in a animal, etc., etc. And then intellect, here it says, with your sattvika intellect. There he said, use the buddhi, man for prani matra ke prati sadbhav ho, buddhi for sad vichar. Sad means sattvik. Sad vichar kya hota hai? Some of you were there when you were listening to Swamiji. Sad vichar kya hota hai? Where do you get sad vichar from? Only satsang. Only satsang and only scriptures. See? These are the only two places. So sad vichar. First step in Vedanta, this is not Vedanta, but Vedanta is discrimination between the real and the unreal. What is real? That which never changes. What is unreal? That which continuously changes. This is sadvichar. Sadvichar is not reading books after books after books after books. Oh, I have read Bhagavad khatam kar di, Upanishad khatam kar di, Bhagavad Gita khatam kar di. Meaning, I have finished Bhagavad Gita, I have finished Upanishads, I have finished Bhagavatam, I have finished Ramayana, I have finished Mahabharata. Finished? You are supposed to finish. You are not supposed to finish them. This is our lot. Because in India you will see some places you go, I have done 550 Gita Gyan Yajna. I had done 700 times Ramayana. I had done 200 times Bhagavat. But I am still there with the big ego. Because I am declaring I had done so many times all these. See the foolishness. Then he says, the sacred vows, austerities, liberality of the yogi who does not duly subdue his speech and mind with his reason leak out unnoticed as water from an unbaked jar. What is baking? See, this story comes in our Maharashtra, where Namdev Maharaj, who was a great devotee of the Lord, and the Lord used to listen to everything that this devotee used to say. And what he used to say, please, someone will say, Namdev Baba, please help, my son is sick, please help him. He will go to the Lord, sing the bhajan, get into the bhava, Lord will come, he said, please help him, and he will help him. Then, he is poor, I am very poor, please ask the Lord to bless me with children, or bless me with wealth, and he will pray to the Lord, and the Lord will do that. But till this was, he was by himself. One day he came across Jnaneshwar Maharaj, Nivrittinath, Jnaneshwar Maharaj, Sopandev, and Muktabai. And when in Pandharpur, in the Vari, and they took him back to Alandi. And when they were sitting one day, they said, he is a very good person, he is a very sattvic person, but he has got the ego of being pure. You understand, that is the biggest problem, that I am pure, that to me God listens. This is an ego. Remember all the siddhis that we did? In the end, all the siddhis come only because of him. If you don't accept that these siddhis are coming from him, you will develop an ego. And this is exactly what happened to Namdev. But again, at the same time, to get the powers, to get the siddhis, your mind has to be pure. Without a purified mind, you will not get siddhis. So they said, and then Muktabai was only 9 years old, Jnaneshwar Maharaj was only 14-15 years old. So they said, who is going to tell? He was like a grandfather to them. They used to call him Azoba. So how do we tell him? They are realized, this fellow is not thinking that these kids, what do they know? Yes, they may be great, but God listens to me. So they told Gorakumbar. Gorakumbar was another realized master who was a potter. Who is a potter? Who makes the pots? Isme kya mushkil hai? Made out of mud. So he was a potter. And how do you check the water pot? You tuck, 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 tuck. If it is a broken noise, then you know it is kacha ghada hai. And you throw it away. This is what is told. Just like from a cracked water pot, the water leaks because it is not baked properly. So they hatch a plan, and for 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, 4 week, 5 weeks, they do not allow Namdev Maharaj to go back to Pandharpur. And he's craving to go back to his Vithala, and they are not allowing him to go. For some reason or other, one day his frustration reaches a level and he's about to go. At that time, they hold a meeting of all Mahatmas, and Gorakumbar comes, and he doesn't understand, because he's when you are not happy with the group, you go and sit in one corner. So Namdev Maharaj, you are sitting under a tree. Why did I listen to them? Why did I come to Alandi? Vithala, why don't you call me back? I'm not getting anything. They are only laughing and this, and I do your bhakti. They don't even do anything except few bhajans every day. Other time they are just laughing and enjoying, as if that's a crime. So that time Gorakumbar comes. He goes to Nivrittinath. Tuck, tuck, tuck. What is that? This is a kumbar. This is a pot. Tuck. This is well baked. Then he went to the next one. Tuck, tuck, tuck. This is well baked. This one. Tuck, tuck, tuck. Well baked. Everyone, Janabai was there, Nivrittinath was there, Muktabai was there, Sopandev was there, Jnaneshwar Maharaj was there, and another few people were there. And eventually, in the last person he comes to is the eldest one, which is Namdev Maharaj. And he goes, tuck, tuck, tuck. And he doesn't say that this is not big. That young girl, 9 years old, Muktabai, she says, hey, kacha ghada hai. She says, this pot is not baked. And everyone laughs. Now, an elderly person ridiculed, he felt ridiculed. Now, from there, he angrily went away to Pandharpur. He didn't care. Itna gussa aa gaya tha ki, why did I stay here to listen to this ridicule from these young people, from they don't even respect my age and this and that. And he went. And immediately, Muktabai told Gorakumbar, he was also elderly, you go after him, because in this madness of his mind, he might drown himself or he might hurt himself. So about 50 spaces, so that he is always able to see him, he went all the way behind him till Pandharpur. See? Kaccha ghada. What are you? We are pot with cracks and we keep putting quick fix. There you go. Eventually he came to know. I told the story last time. See, pakka ho gaya wo. This, because when he reached Pandharpur, I'm not going to tell the whole story. When he reached Pandharpur, he said, Vithoba, why did you keep me away from you so much and this and that? And he went and got the Lord, the statue, and bro, he was hitting his head. Why did you leave me away, send me away from you? Why did you do this? And at that time, the thought came to him that now that I have come back, I'll show that young girl that I'm not a crackpot. I am a fully baked one. And the moment, because his mind is very pure, so the moment he made this commitment to the Lord, that very moment the answer came. Gora Kumbhar was standing right behind him. He turned to go. He says, you want to fix your crackpot? You have to go to this person. And he went there. And from there, that was a butcher. He says, how can a butcher who's cutting meat, how can he tell me who I am? But he told everything that happened without having been there. But he says, I'm not your teacher. Your teacher is that person on that mountain in that Shiva temple. And he went there. And when he goes to see that place, for these people, Namdev and all, every day, puri puja, Bhagwan ki, sab kuch, everything. There he goes, he finds one Mahatma sitting, lying down, sleeping with his feet on the Shivalinga. So he says, hey, nobody there, only this fellow is sleeping there. He says, don't you know this is Shiva temple? You're putting your feet on the Lord Shiva, on the Shivalinga. He says, if you have a problem, I'm sick, I got problem, my blood is oozing, I got no energy, I'm very old, you're still younger than me. If you have got a problem, you lift my feet from the Shivalinga. And he lifted the feet. And where he was going to put, the Shivalinga shifted and came under his feet. Again he shifted. Suddenly, he became baked. That very moment he became baked. He realized that God is not someone that you can, who is at your beck and call. He is the truth everywhere. There you go. So, for that, what do we have to do? To stop the energy from leaking. So if in our, what is a unbaked pot? That the energy is leaking out of the cracks, isn't it? So what are the cracks where the energy is leaking from? First one, speech. Too much talking. Control. Every japa session, every puja session, every bhajan session must conclude in silence. Not teeny mini silence, over. Even after Sanskrit class, when the class finishes, I make them sit. They can't understand meditation. So I tell them, 10 seconds statue. Children understand statue. Statue. Badmash log saans bhi band kar dete hain. Jaise ki bolta hu, okay, Hari Om. Drama. But it must conclude in silence. Why do you wake up every day? Why do you wake up every day? Only for one purpose. So you can go to sleep at night. Why you start thinking every morning? Only so that you stop thinking at night. That is why you start. It's a different way of looking at it. Isn't it? If you look at the total scale of day, the only reason you woke up and started thinking and talking is only to stop everything, isn't it? Do it consciously. Do it consciously. Then the potentiality will start building up. Jo apne ko in the 13th chapter, the exercise which he gave, breathe in, hold, and then breathe out. Isn't it? 10 times. And breathe out and hold and breathe in. And the third exercise was, feel the energy starting from your base of your spine and reaching the top. That holding part is making sure that, you know, when you jump start a car, that is jump starting the car, this machinery. You are invoking that energy. Initially you will get, how I told you, you will not get headache, but if you try something else to hold it longer or try to force, you might get headaches. But you will find your own way around it slowly, if you don't go to the doctor. If you go to the doctor, you will lose it. So, therefore, keeping his eyes fixed on me as his goal. A man should control his mind, speech and breath by means of his intellect full of devotion to me. Thereby he will have reached the end of his journey. And when is the end of the journey? Is it when you die? Is it when you sleep? Is the end of journey that when person dies, we chant Bhagavad Gita, when the person dies, we chant the Padma Puran, Garuda Puran, when the person dies, we say, may his soul go to heaven, and we do the Shraddha. Did you ever wish that for that person while he was alive or she was alive? If that person troubles you, go to hell. Nobody says go to heaven. Correct or not? Today we went to someone's class, house. The boy has to eat whatever mom gives him. And he doesn't want to. And if he doesn't eat, the mom says, if you don't do what I'm saying, I'll throw you out of the house. The door is open. If you don't go, I'll throw you. So he's listening. Fresh example. So he's listening. And then one day he told her, Mummy, when I get old, I will do the same thing to you. I will also throw you and I'll tell you, the door is open. So do we wish, we are ready to read Garuda Puran after the person dies. That is not meant for the dead person. That Garuda Puran is meant for all those people who are alive at the wake of that dead person, that they realize that this is how you have to die. How? Like this last verse of the 15th chapter. Tasman mano vacha pranan niyachet mat parayanaha mat bhakti yuktaya buddhya tatha parisamapyate. Mad bhakti yuktaya buddhya. It is our intellect which makes decisions. You have to make yourself, you have to resolve within your intellect that I must make my mind purified by focusing on the Lord. No other way. Not by looking at sun, not by looking at fire, not by looking at a dot on the wall. Those are also. Whatever I do, even if I do that exercise, I will see the Lord in that. As an offering to the Lord, I will do that. So our main focus is the Lord. with this conclusion that all siddhis are possible only when our mind is purified. Apply yourself now, every day, every moment, in spite of whatever is going on in your life. In the back of your mind, your attention must be, is my mind calm? Is my mind purified? Is my mind expanding? Is my mind single-pointed on the Lord? Is my mouth taking the name of the Lord? Is my mind seeing the Lord in everyone? Is my intellect convinced that Lord is the only truth? Is my intellect continuously saying that everything that is happening in life is by His grace? At a drop of a hat we say, oh, it is my prarabdha. It is not your prarabdha. Wednesday we did the Vivek Chudamani class is going on. In that, this, what is prarabdha? Conclusion, there is nothing called prarabdha. There is nothing called prarabdha. Everything is divine. God or divinity or reality is not a result of karma. Prarabdha comes because of karma. If your attention is on prarabdha, then your attention is not on reality. From God's point of view, there is nothing called destiny or prarabdha. Takes a little bit of courage to swallow that. Now, we come to the, with this preparation of our mind, 13th chapter meditation, 15th chapter, all the siddhis, conclusion, don't get distracted by the siddhis, instead focus only on the Lord, and if the Lord wants those siddhis to express, they will express anyway by His grace. Now, what has happened with the 15th chapter? Your potentiality, as they told there, your potentiality has reached the zenith, climax. It has reached the climax where all possible siddhis are expressing. In Krishna, the same thing was happening, no? At any given moment, all the siddhis were present in him, isn't it? In Arjuna, were they there? No. He didn't reach his full potential. Till the end, he didn't reach his full potential. Choice is yours. Adha Sapta Dasho Dhyayaha, chapter 17.
16.
Eh?
16. God has known
that. Where?
16.
So where I was reading then? मैं 16 एंड पढ़ रहा था क्या? चले यार, फिर मिस कर देते चैप्टर. Anyway, it all connects with each other anyway. That's why you are searching and you couldn't find it. Ah, everyone was searching. चलो, sometimes it's good. But it's all connected. Okay. So yeah. Adha Shodashodhyayaha, chapter 16, glorious manifestations of the Lord enumerated. So we read the first five verses. Uddhava uvacha tvam brahma paramam sakshad anadyantam apavrutam sarvesham api bhavanam tranasthityapyayodbhavah uchavacheshu bhuteshu durgneyam akrutatmabihi upasate tvam bhagavan yathatathyena brahmanah yeshu yeshu cha bhaveshu bhaktya tvam paramarshayah upasina prapadyante sansiddhim tadvadasvame gudascharasi bhutatma bhutanam bhutabhavanah Natvam pashyanti bhutani pashyantam mohitani te yakascha bhumau divimai rasayam vibhutayo dikshu mahavibhute tamahiyam akhyayanubha vitaste namamite tirtha padangri padmam namamite tirtha padangri padmam. my prostrations, my namaskar at the feet of the lotus feet of the Lord. And what are they? They are the tirth. They are the pilgrim. That's the place of pilgrimage. So here he says, Uddhava Uvacha. Now this chapter is also part of Uddhava Gita. Still Uddhava Gita is going on. Tvam Brahma Paramam Sakshad Anadhyantam Apavratam. You are actually the Supreme Brahma. Tvam Brahma, the Creator. Having Paramam, that which is higher than the highest, can never come down. Having no beginning or end and unobscured by Maya. So, Uttama Purusha. In 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, I am the Uttama Purushottama. Uttama Purusha. Who is this Uttama Purusha? He is beyond the perishable and imperishable Brahman. Everything is Brahman. Everything is water. Ocean never dies, wave dies, isn't it? So wave is perishable water, perishable wave, expression of the water, and ocean is imperishable expression of the water. Exactly the same way. Everything is one reality. But the perishable is the individual and imperishable is the Ishvara. And who is this Uttama Purusha? He who is transcendental to both of them. That is another word for it, Paramatma. And that Krishna who is in the form of the body, he says, I am that. So also many Mahatmas say, I am that. We went to one person, some of you met, those who came with me to South India last time. We went to see Durga Swami. First time when I met Durga Swami, we told him, Swamiji, Satya Sabha was doing great work, as if we are validating. Do you know Satya Sai Baba? He says, Satya Sai Baba, the one who made Puttaparthi. I only told him to make Puttaparthi. Or Chinmayananda, yeah, Chinmayananda, yeah, I only inspired him to start Chinmay Mission. And we were nae, abhi ashram se abhi nikle padke. Ye kya, you gone cuckoo or what? Humne kaha, oh, that Baba, oh, I only told him to do that job. This one, I only. And we kept all the Mahatmas that we knew, he kept saying, because on the wall, he had a picture of about 150 Mahatmas for so many centuries. So whichever we knew, he says, I only told him, Shankaracharya. Without my permission, he could not have established Dharma in India. And then he saw us confused. He says, my dear children, even a grain of sand cannot move without my permission in this creation, past, present or future. With that conviction, his eyes were big. You saw him when you were, but even then, you also met him, no? His eyes are intense. And that time even more so in 98. He says, even a grain of sand takes my permission before it moves. Now imagine where that person is established to make that statement. It's not off his head. Same statement Krishna Bhagavan also makes. Think. To that stature, that potential, you have to invoke within yourself. You have to get to that point. So here Bhagavan is saying that transcendental one. So even though Bhagavan is appearing in the form of Krishna here in front of Uddhava, but he is not forgotten who he is. He knows he is the transcendental one. So for him, teaching Uddhava, giving Gita to Arjuna, the Mahabharata war, etc., etc., what is it? Is there a purpose for it? Yes and no. From the transcendental point, no purpose, it's a leela. But at a ground reality, yes, he has come here to establish dharma, and for that purpose, whatever has to happen, has to happen. But he is not happy because there is no war, and he is not feeling bad because so many people have died. Why? Because if you don't do anything, still people are dying. See coronavirus. They're still dying. You didn't do anything. Population is reducing automatically. And you're not doing anything, still population is increasing. Children are being born everywhere, isn't it? See, you have to get out of the societal thinking. For that, the only way you can think outside the parameters of the society, how will you get there? Tell me. How will you get that bird vision? Will you fly into the sky? Then? Yes. Make it more realistic. That is the way, but what will be the result? That you will get clicked out of the societal thinking. Purification. Witnessing is not the answer. Witnessing is only a penultimate step. Purification, purification, purification. Yes, purification by focusing on the Lord. But what is the result? So many priests is also focusing on the Lord. Is he getting purified? That when we did that Changdev Pasashti, 1400 year old yogi, he also purified his mind, but did he offer the purification to the Lord, or he did it only through yogic practices? And he managed to live for 1400 years, but realization was eluding him. Only when Jnaneshwar Maharaj came into his life, then he realized that he has wasted 1400 years. 1400 years wasted. So when you scold your baby, when you cook the food, when you get angry, when you get happy, do you offer it all to the Lord? That you have come here? Are you offering everything to the Lord? Let His will prevail. Hey Saket, all this will help you to become a better person. What are you doing out there? Eating. Hey Chotu, uska naam kya hai? Why you are not listening? Come on. All this is about how to make yourself into a wonderful person. Otherwise, stay home. Listen, not read novels. Kabhi kabhi scold karna padta hai. Parents should do that, not me. Kya karu? So, you are responsible for the protection, subsistence and destruction and birth of all existences, that everything in this creation is born, comes into creation because of you, is maintained in creation because of you, and goes out of this creation, means gets destroyed or unmanifest because of you. Take one example. If we say this statement to the water, oh dear water, oh God water, the oh water God, you are responsible for all the creation of the waves and all the maintenance of the waves and all the destructions of the wave. You are responsible. My pranams to you. Without you, the creation, maintenance and destruction of the wave will not be possible. Is it true statement? Isn't it? Before the wave, water was. During the wave, water is. After the wave, water is. Isn't it? Same way. You are not able to see it right now. Why? Mind is not purified. that before also the divine was there, now also divine is there. After we go away also divine will continue. But we believe that, oh, before me, before this body, what was there? It's a big question. And when children ask the parents, parents are equally confused. Then they stay home and send the children to children's class. Children come and tell, Mommy, you know, I didn't know. The children are teaching. Continuing, Uchavacheshu Bhuteshu Durgnyeyam Krutatmabihi Upasate Tvam Bhagavan Yathatathyena Brahmanaha. The knowers of the real, real import, meaning the reality, the Paramatma Tattva, or the essence of the Vedas, alone worship you. So whom are we talking about here? We are talking about that one which is beyond the perishable and the imperishable, the Paramatma Tattva. What is this Paramatma Tattva? It is attributeless and formless. That water has got no form. Water has got no form. But when surrounded by big land masses, it is called ocean. Isn't it? And when having a small shape, it is called a wave. For whatever reason it has come about. Same way, space has got no form. But when that space is defined by the space above Australia, Australian territory, Australian space, the moment the plane goes from Darwin, Gulf of Carpentaria out, immediately Papua New Guinea space begins. After that, immediately some other country. So space has got no form. We gave it a name, space, but it has got no form. We have built one house. So we say, this is my house. This is my house space. And we put a lock and key as if we have trapped the space inside. You can't. Space inside and outside is the same space. Exactly the same way. Paramatma inside and outside is the same. He cannot be trapped. You think space is trapped, that it is your space and you own it because your attention is on the walls. You think this is Australian space because your attention is on the boundary of the Australian territory. Same way, this Paramatma who's inside, you feel he is inside, trapped. Why? Because your attention is on the shape of the body. Drop the shape of the body. For that you don't have to die. Drop the shape of the body. Every night when you go to sleep, you drop the shape of the body. Isn't it? When Srinika sleeps, she's heavy. She's heavy. Two things are, two times you become heavy. One is when you sleep, and the second is when you die. Two times. Third time is also there. When? When you are sitting in meditation and disidentified from the body. That person also is very heavy. Because mind has dropped the idea of the body. Therefore the body becomes heavy. Three places. See? So that same Paramatma. So here, simple. Here by this verse, the Bhagwan is telling Uddhava, put your attention on the divine rather than on the conditioning. And then he says, though you cannot easily know, perceive by those that have not been able to purify their mind. This statement that I just made and I explained to you, it is, you can understand, but you cannot experience, only for one reason. Why? Your mind is not purified. And how do you purify the mind? Focus on the Lord. Vidhava. If the feeling is not there, bhava is not there, purification will not happen. Mere mechanical chanting of the name will not result. It will result in single pointedness, but it will not result in surrender. Yeshu yeshu cha bhaveshu bhaktya tvam paramarshayah upasina prapadyante samsiddhim tadvadasvame. This is the therefore pray, point out to me. Now Uddhava is asking the question. Yeah, because this was the bhumika. Whenever you want to ask a question, always praise that person. Mummy, you are so sweet. See, she is now keeping Srinika very happy. After that, she'll say, give me all the color pencils. Will you give it to her? No. Even when you go to this Lavanya's house, this is my toy, this is this. You make friendship with her, you're so sweet, you're so loving, you're so giving, you're wonderful, you're the best. And she starts sharing all her ties with you. Bhagwan is exactly the same. Bhagwan is exactly the same. For 1 hour, 45 minutes, for 4:30 to 6 o'clock, na? 1.5 hours. We chanted his name, then 108 names, then bhajan, then kirtan. For what purpose? For what purpose? Only to merge into him, nothing else. If that is not clear in the background of our mind, then the entire exercise of last 1.5 hours plus this half an hour now has gone to waste. So here Uddhavji Maharaj first praises the Lord, and now he asks the question for which he wants a conclusion or answer. Therefore, O Lord, because you are all capable, you are the transcendental, and you alone are the eminent. Even though you are transcendental, yet you are expressing in this creation. You are right in front of me, I am seeing you. Therefore, pray point out to me those particular entities by contemplating on you, through which, with devotion, men of supreme wisdom are able to attain highest perfection in the form of true devotion or saving wisdom. See, he's still not satisfied. Bhagwan already told him. Hoi. Shh. He already told him what? That if you focus on my Chaturbhuj form, that's all. Yet he is asking question. Mind is not settled. He wants to know more. He wants to, because he is recognized. Because what was his question? Remember, 2-3 chapters, 4 chapters before? That, O Lord, my mind is moving in different directions while living in this world. How do I focus upon you? Not everyone's mind is, Bhagwan ne kaha, think of my Chaturbhuj form. And you close your eyes and a bull comes in front of you. Chaturbhuj kaha gaya yaar? And or Bhagwan with two arms come. Arre, do baar kahan gaye? Kahan gaye? Kahan gaye? Dhoond rahe ho meditation mein. See, funny things happen in meditation. Shivratri hui, so soch rahe ho, dheere. Saap kahan gaya yaar? Saap kahan? Ganga, inke upar se Ganga ji to beh rahi hai, par pani kahan hai? सिर्फ फवारा निकल रहा है, पानी कहाँ जा रहा है? इधर उधर देख तो कहीं दिखता ही नहीं है. दिस इज हाउ आवर माइंड ट्रिक्स अस. सो व्हेन सिंपल थिंग चतुर्भुज फॉर्म प्रे टू द लॉर्ड विथ फीलिंग ही विल रिवील. यू कैन नॉट थिंक. अंडरस्टैंड, एवरीथिंग इन आवर लाइफ इज हैपनिंग बाय हिज ग्रेस, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ योर विल. येट यू हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड अ विल, इजंट इट? द फ्रीडम ऑफ चॉइस. How you should exercise that freedom of choice or free will? How? To remember him. Then see, magic happens then. Choose only him to the exclusion of everything else. That's your decision. Nobody else can make it for you. You can hear hundreds of lectures, but the decision has to be your own. Nobody can force you to think in that manner.
So the will is
huh?
The will power what we exercise, it's only two ways. Either we can focus it towards the Lord or away from it. That's the only option.
If you focus it on the Lord, it will purify your mind.
Yes.
If you focus it on the world, it will destroy your mind. What is destruction of the mind? Eventually, depression. Eventually, attachment. Eventually, before death, no contentment. Physical death, no contentment. Or even while living, no contentment. Contentment does... World, which is continuously changing, can never give you a peace of mind. You should have seen. Mere saath abhi sab aaye the ye mataye. I left, I took the leash off on the 13th day. You can't imagine how much shopping they did. And one day, I said, I am not coming. Raj was there and Shri was there. So, I didn't go with them. In Ahmedabad. We had half a day. So I said, Jaipur. I said, I am not coming with you guys. I don't want to see the Hawa Mahal and the palace and this and that. You go. So Raj, he took them everywhere. And as a macho man, he said, I'll take care of them. I'll take them to the shopping also. So he went to the shopping. And whatever happened, I don't know the story. He came back. I was sitting in the restaurant. I said, you come here at 1:30. He, Swamiji, how do you handle it? I can't. You turn here. I tell them, wait here. I'll call. Go and call others. I go to call. These three vanish. Then he goes and tells them, you wait here 3 minutes. I go call them. He comes back. These three vanish. He says, I am not taking responsibility for these people again. And half an hour later, Shri comes. Shri, more melodramatic. I am not going with these ladies again. This is what happens. This is what happens when your attention is on the world. This is what happens when your attention is on
the world.
They
took their duty very seriously.
Very seriously. Very right. Few more trips and few more responsibilities, they will learn the lesson. But if I had a video recorder that time, it was worth capturing those two moments. The expressions on their face. And the ladies immediately afterwards, all of them came. And each one, forget about ordering food. They're showing, I bought this, I bought that, I bought this, I bought that. Oh, did you buy this? Oh, I didn't buy that. Oh, I got this. I bought this. Forever. Itna maja aa raha tha. Aur fir uske baad itna nahi. Table pe baith gaye. What are you eating? Oh, what? They had to order. I didn't even take responsibility of ordering for their food also. You order. So this one ordered dosa. And then she was ordering, I want puri. What did you take? Masala dosa. Achha, cancel my puri, I will take it. What, there is puri? She says, I will cancel my masala dosa, I will take puri. The waiter was confused. And the responsibility for taking the dishes, because we had to buy the coupon, was Shri's. It was a scene to watch. This happens when your attention is on the world. The world is continuously changing. That was a perfect example for you. See? So, conclusion, when our mind is focused on the Lord, it becomes purified and becomes single-pointed. When it is, or love, And when the love is for the world, it becomes broken up into many things. And that leads to breakup of personality. Whereas when we think of the Lord, our personality gets integrated. When we think of the world, our personality gets disintegrated. When you are thinking of the world, I am a mother, I am a daughter, I am a sister, I am a brother, different roles, sometimes it becomes too much. My God, which one should I be more serious about? See? But if you allow those roles and be the woman, no confusion. Ho gaya to ho gaya, nahi hua to nahi hua, khatam baat. So therefore, he says that, therefore point out to me those particular entities. What are the different manifest forms of yours or those entities in this creation who have contemplated, who have contemplated upon you or on whom we can contemplate, through which with devotion men of supreme wisdom are able to attain the highest perfection. Which forms? Highest perfection in the form of true devotion or saving wisdom. So what is true devotion? True devotion must lead us to surrender to the deity that we are thinking of contemplating upon. Then he says, Gudascharami bhutatma bhutanam bhuta bhavanaha na tvam pasyanti bhutani pasyantam mohitani te. The inner controller of beings, you remain hidden from their view. I'll explain. This is very simple. People make it complicated. The inner controller of beings, you remain hidden from their view, meaning God is the inner controller of all of us. How does he control you from inside? Think. Does he control you by becoming the mind? Does he control you by becoming the intellect? Does he control you by becoming the indriyas? Does he control you by becoming the memories? Does he control you by becoming the ego, the I? Does he control you by becoming the attachment inside of you? How does he control you? Think till I answer it. You remain hidden from their view, O life giver of all created beings. Deluded by you, living beings are unable to perceive you, even though you behold them all, even though you are holding the entire creation of all the beings. The beings are not able to see you. We see him where? Or we make an attempt to see him where? By going to pilgrimage. We see him where? By doing puja. This is very special. Narmadeshwar. And if another human being comes, then that Narmadeshwar is more important than the human being. This is where we are going wrong. Think. Whom are you respecting? Are we respecting the human beings or are we respecting the inert? And why is this? Our mind is in the right place. We want to pray to the Lord. But we look at the personality of the person and therefore keep him one arm away. We look at the personality of the Shivalinga. What? Narmadeshwar. It is of a shape of Shivalinga. Or that statue is of the shape of, or that photograph is the shape of a particular god. And to that particular form, I have given or attributed the divinity, that it is of this god and it is of great importance. And therefore, that god is appearing in the form of all beings in front of us. We don't respect them, but we respect But he is equally present there also, and he is equally present in the sentient also, in the inert also and in the sentient also. But where is your attention? Now, understand, how is he the inner controller? Now, if I open you up, how? You know, like you open the peel of onions, andar kya milta hai? Kya bola? Kuch nahi. What is there inside? Kuch nahi. Another word for it? Another word for it? There is nothing, there is shunya. Another word for it? Starts with S. Space. If you take the banana, stem, and they are all over on. If you take out, what is there inside? Empty space. What is the creation made out of? What is the subtlest of elements? Space. Then from space came air, then fire, then water, then earth, isn't it? Now, because air, fire, water, earth have come out of space, have they displaced space wherever they are expressing? Where water is expressing, is there space or no space? Where earth is expressing, is there space or no space? There is space. Without space, earth cannot express as earth. Without space, water cannot express as water. Without space, fire cannot express as fire. Without space, air cannot express as air. Without space, these bricks cannot express as bricks. Science tells you that if you take the brick and you start breaking it down to the atomic level, what will you find? 99.999% empty space, because in every atom, every atom, the total mass of electrons and neutrons is only minuscule. Rest is all empty space, but yet it is giving you the illusion of gross. What is this due to? Why is your attention on the solid? Why can't you see the empty space where there is solid? Why can't you see the consciousness, conscious space which is expressing through this solid? This solid, this solid, this solid. Why? Because? Okay, now my attention is, she's alive. So have you come to know now? What is the reason? No. Jada hi-fi mat bol. Simple. Only one reason. Your mind is not purified. As the mind purifies, automatically these truths, subtle truths, they start, one by one, they start revealing. And as they reveal, with them siddhis also come. But the reason we are still stuck in seeing the gross and not able to access the subtle is because of our impure mind. And what is impurity? Don't leave it unconcluded. What is impurity? Exactly. Thinking about anything else other than the Lord is the impurity. Sir, that is not practical to live. Yes, it is not practical. So what do? Keep doing whatever you are doing, but keep offering it to the Lord. Slowly, slowly, the next step will reveal to you. But start somewhere. Continuing. The inner controller, just like the water is the inner controller of every wave, just like the gold is the inner controller of every ornament, same way this Paramatma is the inner controller of every being. And our attention is on the form, therefore we are missing him. even though he is very, very accessible, but we are not able to be one with him. We are not able to recognize him. Therefore, truth is not a destination. It's a discovery. You have to remove the covering. Discover means you remove the covering and discover what is hidden. When you remove the covering of the onion, you discover there is nothing inside. You discover annamaya kosh, pranamaya kosh, manomaya kosh, vijnanamaya kosh. When you remove one by one peels off this body, what remains behind? Conscious, without going to sleep. If you are conscious, then what remains behind? What is in the core? The inner controller, the consciousness. He continues, even though you behold them, so he alone is holding the whole creation together by expressing as the core of the creation. You know, in Upanishads, the thought comes that because he is expressing through you, he is expressing through you, which means, is the reality different here and different there and different there and different here? It is the one reality. It's not like that. Ya akashcha bhumau divi vai rasayam vibhutayo dikshu maha vibhute tamahiyamakhyahyanubhavitaste namamite tirta padangri padmam. Mention to me all those powerful manifestations of yours invested by you with your own divine glory that may be existing on earth in the quarters, in the heaven, or in the subterranean region. O Lord of infinite prowess, I bow to your lotus feet, which are the abode of all sanctuaries. See, here he says, mention to me all those powerful manifestation of yours. Really speaking, every aspect of this creation is his manifestation alone. Every wave on the ocean is a manifestation of the infinite waters alone. Every ornament is the manifestation of the gold alone. Everything in this creation, in this entire universe or universes, is the manifestation of the divine alone. We have to develop the eye to see it. So here Uddha Maharaj is saying that invested by you, by your divine own divine glory. So please tell me, what are those specific manifestations where you are more than required manifesting with your powers for the benefit of the people? Even though he is expressing through you, me, everyone, but whom do we go for blessings? We go to Mahatmas, you know? We go to realized masters, or we go to gods, isn't it? That's why we do Satyanarayan Puja, Shivratri, etc., etc. Because that Shivalinga is the manifestation of the Lord in that particular form. We have given that value, isn't it? And how did, was it some one person's creation, this Shivalinga? Was it someone's crazy idea? Okay, let's put these two pieces together and it becomes a Shivalinga. No, it is his direct manifestation. It's his direct manifestation, where he has chosen to manifest in that particular form with his full power, to a large amount of power or full power, depending upon the focus and purity of the devotee. But the person can focus on that and come to know the reality. Person can focus on the Chaturbhuj form and come to know the reality. If not that, person can focus on Om and come to know the reality. Different, all the names, they are just not names, they are forms also, because every name must have a form. So he says that mention to me all those powerful manifestations of yours, meaning those special powerful manifestations which have helped millions and millions of people or to focus upon, where you are expressing yourself with lots with your powers invested by you with your own divine glory. So which are these forms? These forms are not the ones which are born through the womb. They appear to be, but they are, what are they? Avatar. Manifestation means the avatar. They are that Lord, that infinite one himself has descended on the earth in a particular form for a particular purpose with certain powers or capacities in order to fulfill a particular task. So we know only about 10 of them, isn't it? One more coming. But apart from that, there are many more. Ved Vyasa is there, for example, which is not mentioned in the 10 avatars, but he's there. So like that. So here he says that in heaven or in the subterranean region, not only in the higher worlds, but also in the lower worlds, because creation cannot be only the goody-goody. Creation is always a balance of opposites. Your day cannot be only day. Go to Norway and you will find out how frustrated they are. Because no night. Their night begins after 6 months. And then 6 months night, and then 6 months day. You are lucky. You get four seasons in a day. Every day, or everything is getting manifested. So, oh Lord of infinite capacity, I bow at your lotus feet, which are the abode of all sanctuaries. They are the Teeth Padangri Padmam. So, with this, I think we'll conclude today. And we'll see what the Lord answers to Uddhava from next class onwards. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Lavanya, cry. Now you are allowed to cry. Cry now. Cry. Cry. Attitude. Quick, don't waste time.
Sarala bhava se hari bhaje jo. Shubha Charana
tama guna sadhana chetana mayo harani lakanta sai nama mayo harani lakanta sai
Shankara Shiva Shankara Shiva Shankara Shambho
Shankara Shiva, Shankara Shiva, Shankara Shambho. Namah Parvati Padaye Har Har Mahadev. Why so much noise? Enough? Chalo, Harti. करो एक ही करो जगह कहाँ है क्या मैं यहीं से करेगा तुम वहाँ से करो मैं यहाँ से करता हूँ मैं भागवत की करूँगा तुम भगवान की करो एक ही में दोनों हो जाएगा यार टू इन वन